Hello, this is Dr. Rohde. This tutorial will show how to use the TI84 calculator to find descriptive statistics, particularly the mean, the standard deviation, and the five-number summary, including the min and max, the quartiles, and the median. So we have an example here. Charles Jenkins obtained a random sample of 15 adult males and measured their heights in inches. The data are listed below. So the first step is to take this data and type it into the data list in the calculator. And what you want to do, use the stat button, and then you're going to choose edit. We have these choices. We can edit, we can calculate, or we can run test. What we want to do is edit a list, and that's the very first choice. We're already highlighting it. So you can type the number one, or you can hit enter. And then what you want to do is just come in here and type in these numbers. For instance, I'll retype the first one just to show you. You hit 68 and then hit enter, and it'll toggle down to the next space, and you continue typing in all the numbers until the data set is populated. In this case, I've preloaded the data to save some time. Now to the calculation. In order to do the calculation, I again use the stat button, but this time I'm going to choose calc for calculate. So I'm going to arrow to the right. Now notice I have a bunch of choices. What I want to do is, since I only have one variable here and I'm interested in the descriptive statistics, I want to choose one var stats, which stands for one variable statistics. Again, I can choose the number one, or I just highlight to it, which that's the very first one, and hit enter. Now it brings me to this menu. Now notice the default list is list one, and that's why I like to use list one when I'm doing problems. I can use any list I choose because I can put in here whatever list my data is in and ask it to calculate the statistics based on that list. And the way to do that is to hit the second button and then just choose the number corresponding to the list. Because if you notice, above each number in blue is L1, L2, and so on. But the default is list one, so if you choose list one, it makes life a little easier. I could ignore this frequency list. I'm going to arrow down, just leave that frequency list blank, and then I'm going to cursor and highlight the word calculate. And I simply hit enter. And now this is my output screen. There's a lot of information on the output screen, and I'll point out the parts that are relevant to this particular example. The sample mean here, x bar, that would be this first number here, 68.06 repeating. The sample standard deviation is right here, s sub x, 3.534 and so on. Now this particular problem said that Charles Jenkins obtained a random sample. So we are finding the standard deviation of a sample, and most of the time that will be the case. And so we want to use S sub X, or S, rather than sigma, because the sigma represents the population standard deviation. And it's rare that you'll actually be calculating the population standard deviation, because it's rare that you have access to the entire population. Virtually every time you do a problem, you're going to be doing the sample standard deviation. But read each problem carefully, so that you know which one to use. And in this case, the dead giveaway is that you have a random sample, so you want to use the sample standard deviation S. N is the sample size. So that's a good way to verify that you typed your data in right. You should always scroll through and double check your typing. But I know I have 15 data points, and my sample size here is listed as 15. That helps. I arrow down, and if I scroll down to the bottom, I see in front of me my five-number summary. The min and the max, the two quartiles, and the median. So this is how you use the TI84 to compute descriptive statistics.